Hey everyone, it's Erik from MAPerformance.com. Today we're going to look at the brand new DeatschWerks DW300C drop-in 340 liter per hour fuel pump. This pump will fit many applications including the Evo 10, GTR, Legacy GTs, and STI. This pump is really going to change the fuel pump market. Never before has there been a direct fit pump that could flow 340 liters per hour. The DW300C has the same excellent fuel delivery of the DW300, but in the housing of the very popular DW65C. At 43 PSI, the DW300C flows 340 liters per hour at 13 volts. This means you will have the fuel to support all stock frame turbo upgrades on the market without modifying your fuel sending unit. We are going to show you just how easy it is to replace your old pump with the new DW300C. Let's begin with the removal of the old pump. The fuel pump and housing is located under the rear driver's side seat. There are two tabs on the bottom of the seat. Pull up on the seat to unclip the tabs and remove the seat. Remove the fuel sending unit by pulling up. It is only held on with sealant. Disconnect the wiring harness from the cover and set it aside. Next is the feed line, return line, temp sending unit, and main power harness. Disconnect and unplug all four. You will need to use a flathead screwdriver to unplug the feed line, and a pair of pliers to remove the return line. Next, remove the six 8mm bolts. Remove the sending unit mounting ring. We recommend getting a plastic bag to place over the pump once it is removed, as it can get pretty messy. The sending unit can be a little tricky to remove sometimes, so try moving it side to side at an angle to slide it out of the fuel tank. Remember to remove the crossover line from the bottom of the sending unit before removing completely. Place the pump in the bag and that will complete the removal of your fuel pump housing. Next, we are going to bring it over to our workbench. Unplug the two fuel pump wires from the fuel pump hat. Next, push down on the top and remove the C-clip here. Be careful to not send it shooting off into the shop. Lift up on the three tabs holding the fuel pump housing in the sending unit. The pump housing can now be separated from the sending unit. Remove the plastic mounting ring from the housing. Next, remove the old pre-filter. This can be tricky, so be patient. The filter sock should pop off after some finagling. The fuel pump can slide right out of the bottom. Remove the power wire from the old pump and plug it into the new one. Remove the two blue caps off the top and bottom. Take the two supplied O-rings and lube both with the supplied lube and slide them onto the new pump. Be sure to remove the old O-ring if it was stuck in the housing. Place the new fuel pump inside. Snap the new sock in place. It should only go on one way. Take a clean rag and wipe out the inside of the housing to clear it of debris. Don't forget to clip the fuel housing mounting ring back into place. Next, put the pump into the housing. Make sure all four tabs are locked down tight. Replace the fuel hat and replace the C-clip. Plug the harness back in and you're all set. Reverse the uninstall process and you're ready to roll. This pump is listed with these features: 340 liters per hour, compact fitment drop-in applications, quiet and reliable turbine impeller, E85 compatibility, and a 3-year warranty. Keep in mind, we installed ours on our Evo 10, but this pump is also available for a wide variety of platforms, including Subaru, Ford, Honda, Toyota, and Nissan. That wraps up our first look at the DeatschWerks DW300C fuel pump. We wanted to thank DeatschWerks for sending us their new pump to install and test out. Get your hands on one of the smallest and best flowing fuel pumps at MAPerformance.com.